Alright guys, it is Pughy here doing another replay analysis, and we have a PVT lined up. This is actually quite a short game, as you guys can see. It's only 8 minutes, so I will try to stretch it out as long as possible and give as much advice as I can. The person did actually request to email to replay analysis. I won't do that just yet. I'll go through all the replays that I've already had, because of course it's like that's the fair thing to do. So this person is, does it see the rank? I don't believe it does. So, I'm just going to commentate. I'm guessing if you died to a 2 rax and doesn't really know how to respond, you're looking around, I know, he's going to be about goldish level. He also sent me replays under 15 minutes, which is what I suggested for bronze to gold. So, I'm going to say around gold. Like, this is an assumption. So, we go for the 9 scout, which is fine. I'm not going to comment on that. At your level, in my opinion, it's better to have the earlier map information or game information than have the extra economy, because at your level you're not capable of really turning that extra bit of money into a, you know, a solid advantage or whatever. So you go for the scout. I like this. When you go for a 9 scout, you can get away with the harassing, and you go up around the base, you see the gas, really good, and you keep running around. You can keep doing this. I would come back down here and then start attacking this, because once your shields regenerate, why wouldn't you? Like, you don't, like, you might as well. It's crazy not to just do 20 damage, wait till he probes at its armor, and then run away. Alright, so we have second rex going down. Now at this point, when you see the first gas, you have to know that the Terran is more than likely going to be doing some sort of pressure, right? It can span from anything realistically, because he could get a second gas, but you kind of have to know that he's not going for a straight up command center first, you know, after the racks. It's going to be something normally. It can be, but it's very rare. And that is why, when the Zealot, you produce the Zealot, you produce your Stalker, and then you move across the map and try to have a little poke. But with the gas, you just have to be very wary. Normally, if I see a gas, I don't expand. I'll play some funky builds. I might do like a 2-gate expansion or 3-gate expansion, just because this is what you expect. A 2-rex is what you expect. A 3-rex or stim or something like that is normally what happens off one gas. It can vary. Like, if you see a very, very early gas, like a gas before the barracks, it can, that's normally a reactor helium build, but like I said, there's a lot of variances. So I don't know why you would, this is pretty bad. I just unpaused you this pause again. Alright, you chrono boost your Zealot, which I don't really agree with. Your Zealot's at 13 seconds, which means it has 25 seconds left, and your sub next goes 25 seconds. So there's like an overlap of like 5 seconds with the Chrono Boost already. So, like, it doesn't really matter so much. Like, we'll see now that the Zealot will finish before the Warp Gate, and then, like, you're just not using your Gateway for an extra minute, you know, an extra couple seconds, which is the waste of a Chrono Boost, because, like, you might as well use the production time while the Warp Gate, the Cyber Core is finishing, see? It just doesn't work out. You waste a Chrono Boost. Show me a Stalker, then Chrono Boosted that if you felt unsafe. So we have a 2-rax come down. It's a reactor, yeah. That's normally what you get. The Zealot's still in the base. Chrono Boost in the Warp Gate, no problem with that. Now I want to see what you react with. Normally you don't see an SCV in the base for this launch, so you should be able to kill this as it escapes, but it doesn't look like you want to, and you go for a 1-gate expand, which is, it can be very difficult, I must say, so I'm guessing you do die to this. And also, like I said, against a 1-gas expand, you have, no, a 1-gas Terran, because you don't know what he's doing, just be very careful with the expansions. Very careful. Like, you should be, you know, like you're doing now, chrono boosting this, but you know, you should have your extra gateways down by now, because your Wolfgate's tech's not going to finish, but I'm guessing this is what's coming. One gateway, second gateway. It's cool. You've got... How long has that Stalker been done for? Stalker's been done quite a while. Before you've decided to... Well, you should build another unit, is what I'm getting. You had enough gas for a sentry, which is what you should have built. Because you might... I don't know what the timing is exactly, but we will see. I wonder if his Turax gets to your base before the command the Nexus finishes. And you just saw that more order, so you should be like, okay, something's coming. So, that's done. You should be adding on an extra building. You're going to be supply blocked in a second. You took too long to build that. When you realize, like, you're... I don't know, well, I hope you realize that you're about to be supply blocked. If you're up here and you're like, okay, I need a pylon, should build one here, and then, like, here as well. Because, obviously, like, that distance to get from there to here is... It's time that you're not going to have back, which you need. Like, if you're facing pressure, you know, that can be the warping. That can be the whole difference of getting that sentry out just in time to get the force field. Which, if you already had one more sentry out, and then you needed the extra to get the force field... On the ramp, it works. But it's not. It's that. So. You haven't built anything. Why haven't you built any units? Oh my god. Well, no wonder why you die. You're not building shit. What the f. You're like, hoop, doop, doop. I see pressure coming. Let me not build anything. And now you decide to build stuff. Oh, but they're buildings. You still... Okay, there we are. Three sentries when he's in your base. That's not going to do anything. Oh my god. That was such a bad decision. Oh my god. As you can see from the web camera, my expression is not very good. Why would you build in sentries then? Like... Why would you do them when you're being attacked? You need the sentries beforehand to stop them getting into your base. That's, like, defeating the purpose of the sentries. Like, the sentries aren't really for fighting, which is what they were then. And, yeah, of course you're gonna lose after that. Like, let's watch that again, just to point out to you. Because, like, not to be rude, but you shouldn't be needing to send me this replay to figure out what's wrong. It's pretty freaking obvious. You didn't build units before you were attacked, when you could have. Like, right, so Wolfgate's already done. This hasn't been turned into a build, Wolfgate. Alright, so there's that. Okay, now it is. Now it is, that's cool. Alright. Alright, pylons, you're not supply blocked, so you could be warping in your unit right now. You could have had your sentry. Could have had your sentry, definitely. Second one finishes. Third one finishes. So. Actually, I'm gonna go over this again. I want to count exactly how long until your first warp gate turned into a, your first gateway turned into a warp gate. So that turned into a warp gate at about 43 seconds, and then the rest of them kick in at about, say, 5 seconds past. All your units die, and then you warp in the sentries. Fair enough. These two were used about 10 seconds after, but this one took about 30 seconds. It was about 45, it was actually 43, and that's obviously 30 seconds. So, you missed an extra unit because of that. If you built a unit from this straight away, if you corner boosted it, could have had an extra one out. You know, if you had a sentry straight away, and then these two finish, and then you had one sentry, like, you're gonna have an extra unit. If you built an extra unit out of this before your Wolfgate, while your Wolfgate was being researched, that would be an extra sentry. Then 30 seconds go when Wolfgate finishes, you have an extra sentry. That's two sentries. By the time they build up energy, you have like four force fields. It only takes two force fields to block this off. So one force field there, one force field there, and you just stop the pressure. And then if you have another two force fields, you stop it again. And guess what that buys you? That buys you more warp-ins. That buys you time for your gateways to finish. That buys you time for the robo, the immortal, to start and finish. It makes a big freaking difference, man. And then you warp in sentries to fight. Sentries aren't for fighting, bro. Oh, I feel this is painful to watch. So yeah, immediately, like, I've criticized your build order a massive amount. Which is good, because, like I said, if you're in gold, this is like, if you can't play 10 minutes straight up, like, there's no point going to the late game. So I'm happy that you went for a replay that I believe will actually benefit you by me and analyzing it. So I think this is really good for yourself in terms of progressing now. But, oh god, that's so painful. To see the sentries being warped in, that's so painful. I don't know why he's going for an NG bay. So he had stim. Yeah, he had stim researching, and he of course went for mortar. So you warp in a couple extra units up here. Should just sack this. Don't run down the ramp. That finishes. But it's just too late now. You've lost way too much. He's lost a marine. I think he lost a harvester, that's it. No. One marine you killed. So there's no harvesters killed for you. There's only one unit, so you killed a marine. That was it. And I don't understand why. Like, you should have been able to figure this out. Fair enough, you wouldn't be able to, like, nitpick everything like I have, but you should have been able to watch this game and be like, oh well, I didn't build anything from my three gateways until all my units died and he was in my base. Like, obviously that's your issue. That's the problem. So, yeah, I think I should have covered everything pretty well. Like, I don't have to really comment on much else. So, there we are, guys. Thank you all for tuning in. I hope this has improved your play, especially Jin's here. Hopefully this will really help him. So there we are, guys. Thank you for all tuning in, and take care. Goodbye.